Hello guys, Dr. Hasbullah here, and in this video we're going to be working on a tutorial about an impulse turbine. So basically what you have here is a Pelton wheel that rotates at the rotational velocity of 400 rpm, and the power output of this wheel is 67.5 kilowatts. Okay, and this is power output, so this is W dot T. And we also know that the head of the turbine is 60 meters of water. And there are a few other information that we know, such as CV, which is 0.97, and phi, which is 0.46. And also the efficiency, the turbine efficiency, is 0.83, which is 83%. Okay, then what does the question want? The question wants three things, which is A, the volume flow rate, or Q, and B, the question is looking for the diameter of the jet. Okay, so let's call this DJ, and then C is the wheel diameter of the wheel. Okay, so if I draw the Pelton wheel here, right, and you have a few buckets around the wheel, and let's say that the nozzle is here. Okay, this is the nozzle that shoots water into the bucket. And if I take the distance from the center of the wheel rotation, this is called R. Okay, that is the radius of the wheel. So 2 times R is the diameter of the jet, which is question C just now. So basically what question C is looking for is 2 times R, right? And do not confuse the diameter of the jet and diameter of the wheel. Okay, when we say diameter of the jet, it is solely focused on this bit. Okay, if I zoom that in, right? Okay, and this nozzle is shooting jet. Okay, so this is the diameter of the jet, or DJ. It is completely different than diameter of the wheel. So please do not get confused. Okay, anyway, let's try and find the volume flow rate first. Judging from the information that we have, okay, there are a few things that is very useful, which is the turbine efficiency. Let's write the equation for turbine efficiency. This is going to be the work output of the turbine divided by the work input from the fluid, isn't it? So this is W dot T over W dot F. Okay, and I think we have the value of W dot T, which is 67.5 kilowatts, right? So this is W dot T over W dot F, and W dot F is simply rho GQ HT, right? I think we have everything that we need to solve this equation. We have eta T, we have W dot T, we have rho G and HT. So what you need now is Q, the volume flow rate. So Q is going to be equal to W dot T divided by rho G HT eta T, and this is going to be 67500 divided by 9810 times HT is 60 meter times eta T is 0.83, and I'll end up with 0.138 meter cube per second. Remember, this is volume flow rate, so the unit is meter cube per second. So there you go, this is the answer for question number one, right? So 2 more to go. How do we find the diameter of the jet? I think in order to get the diameter, you need the area of the jet first. Okay, and area and velocity is related with Q, which is what we just found, which is 0.138 meter cube per second. And Q is also equal to velocity times area. Of course, this is the velocity of the jet, and this is the area of the jet. Okay, and we have the queue now, right? And we are looking for area of the jet, okay? Because from the area, we can get the diameter, isn't it? Right? So how do we find V jet? So the velocity of the jet, if we are looking for the equation that we've done before, this is it, right? So this is the velocity of the jet, which is equal to CV square root 2GHT. Okay, so the velocity of the jet is CV square root 2GHT. Right, and I believe we have all the values that we need in order to find this velocity. Right, so CV is 0.97 square root of 2 times 9.81 times 60. So your VJet is going to be 2 times 9.81 times 60 square root times 0.97. This is 33.28 meter per second. Okay, so that's your jet velocity. Remember, you don't want velocity, you want the diameter. But to find the diameter, you need area first. So the area of the jet is going to be Q divided by VJ. This is 0.138 divided by 33.28. And the area is going to be 0.138 divided by answer. This is 4.15 times 10 to the minus, to the power of minus 3 meter square. Okay, and remember this is area and you're looking for diameter. So area is equal to pi d jet square over 4. And this is equal to 4.15 times 10 to the power of minus 3. So I'll end up with diameter of the jet, which is equal to pi squared. This is going to be 0.073 meter, or we can write it as 73 millimeter. So that's your diameter of the jet. Now think about the answer. 73 millimeter is about 7 cm, so it's about this big, okay? And the velocity of the jet is 33 meter per second. So 33 meter per second is about 100 kilometer an hour, right? So that's quite fast, right? With this big, so no wonder that this turbine can generate about 67.5 kilowatt of power output. So it looks okay now. The answer makes sense to us. Okay. Now you got the second answer, which is the diameter of the jet. Now finally, you are looking for diameter of the wheel, which is 2R. Now, to find this R, we need to go back to our equation before, and I believe this is the right equations that we can use. Alright, so phi is equal to R omega divided by square root of 2GHT. Let's write it again. Phi is equal to R omega divided by square root 2GHT. Right, and remember, we are looking for R. Okay, we are looking for R. So R is equal to phi times 2GHT square root divided by omega. Okay, and omega is the rotational speed. This is in radian per second. What we have here in the parameters that were given to us, this is in RPM. Okay, so first you need to convert RPM to radian per second. And how do you convert it? It's quite simple. So omega is equal to 2 pi n divided by 60. So this is 2 pi. Our n is 400. Times 400 divided by 60. So that's 2 pi times 400 divided by 60. This is 41.89 radian per second. Okay, now we can find R. Okay, so R is going to be phi. Phi is 0.46 square root 2 times 9.81 times, I believe HT is 60, divided by 41.89. So you end up with R equal to 0.377 meter. Okay, or this is 377 millimeter. Alright, remember the question is asking for diameter. So diameter is simply 2R. So diameter of the wheel is equal to 2 times R. This is 2 times 377, which is equal to 753 millimeter, right? And this will be your answer. And again, think about the scale of what's happening here. You know that the jet is about this, and this is 73 millimeter, and the wheel is about 0.8 meter, so close to 1 meter, about this big, right? So you have a jet that is impacting on the wheel this big. So I think that makes sense, right? I think I may have made a mistake here. So this is 753 millimeter. If you have that sense of scale, so you know that the jet is this big and the wheel is this big, so you know that your calculation makes sense. So that means it is the correct answer. If you find, let's say, a diameter of the jet is bigger than the diameter of the wheel, then you know that something is not correct. Maybe you've made a mistake in punching your calculator, or maybe you've made a mistake on the decimal places, maybe you've made a mistake on units. So then check your answer again and again. Okay guys, I think this is it for our tutorial for impulse turbine or Pelton wheel. So this is quite a simple tutorial, quite a simple solution as well. Usually the solution of Pelton wheel is much simpler than the solution of Francis turbine, simply because there is no velocity triangle involved. So it's quite direct, as long as you know the equation. So please familiarize yourself with the equations in our previous video, and then come back here and do the tutorial. Okay guys, that's all from me for now. Thank you very much. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.